Hi everyone, I hope that you are safe, I hope that you are well, and I hope that you are staying at home if you are still under lockdown laws. Remember, this is for everyone's protection and well-being, so it is so important that we all do the right thing. Now, the other day on my Instagram account, I shared an image with my best and most fabulous frugal budget beauty saving hacks. These are things that have saved me a lot of money during Frugal February that have been really helpful during isolation and lockdown. And you guys loved the post, and I was reading through the comments, and then I came across this particular comment. It was from someone working on the front line as a healthcare professional. They were struggling in juggling the intensity of work whilst looking after their children and also maintaining a sense of self-care. And they asked if I would make a special video for them, sharing with them and everyone else, obviously, the things that I do for self-care to help recharge my batteries and get my mojo back, because we all get a bit flat and a bit yucky every now and again. That's perfectly normal. So I am making this video especially for you and especially for everyone on the front line. This is my opportunity to say a massive thank you to everyone who has stepped up on the front line. We are all incredibly grateful and we are all incredibly humbled by your dedication and care for everyone as we get through this very challenging time. Now, before I share with you these 7 self-care hacks that help recharge my batteries, I want to let you know about how I set the scene first. To me, self-care must be done actually in isolation. I really need some time alone to myself, and I am a busy working mum with a 9-month-year-old and a child that's just about to turn 7 and a partner that works crazy hours and really long hours. So for me, having some alone time is incredibly important, and these are the things that I follow to make sure that if I'm investing my time in some sort of form of self-care, I get my best return on investment. So this is what I do. I will make sure if I need time alone, I communicate that. I will say, for example, to Tom, honey, I really need 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours to recharge my batteries. I'm about to lose it. I'm at the end of my tether. Can you please help me? So communication is key. Now, to make sure that I get the most out of the time, I will often put on a set of headphones because that blocks out background noise. It will block out any construction noise nearby, things that are just going to distract me or make me want to leave the room. And then, of course, I will always make sure I close the door. This is really important because it means I'm in the bubble of self-care. All right, what do I do? Now, the things that I'm going to share with you, there's 7 of them, and I'm going to start with the most important first because these are the ones that quickly refill my bucket and are the best investment of my time for self-care. All right, number 1. Beauty. When I stop and invest some time in taking care of my physical appearance, it is a huge valuable investment of my time. And I'm not talking about caking a whole part of makeup and, you know, doing all these elaborate things. No, just stopping and taking the time to honor the way that I present myself. Sometimes that might be just something really simple, like tweezering my eyebrows. But most often than not, it's a little bit more. It's putting on a beautiful face mask. It is stopping to take the time to not just slap on some moisturizer like I normally do, but actually stopping and taking the time to massage a really beautiful moisturizer into my body. And then stopping and taking the time to apply a beautiful fake tan. I love fake tan. I don't have time to go in the sun and I don't want to do that to my skin because I definitely don't want to obviously add premature aging to my skin. When I have fake tan on my face, I feel like I look a little bit more alive and I have a healthier glow about myself. So for me, you know, having a beauty routine as part of my self-care routine is incredibly important. I feel great. And of course, if I'm really tight on time, sometimes self-care is just putting on an extra layer of mascara. I will not leave the house without mascara. I feel naked without it. And putting on a beautiful lip gloss. That's what makes me feel good and that will quickly recharge my batteries. So number 2 is creative play. Whilst I'm letting that moisturizer sink in and absorb in or letting that fake tan dry, I love to play in my wardrobe. I love to stop and take the time to make sure it is neatly organized, put things back in place where they should be. You know, sometimes there are times where I'm in a hurry and I kind of throw things back in. I use this time to get back on top of that, make sure everything's neatly organized, color coordinated again. But the best thing about this time is it allows me to put together new and interesting outfits that I haven't necessarily thought about putting together again. Now, in doing this, it also gives me a sense of gratitude because I realize actually I have everything that I need. I don't need anything more, and it removes and completely reduces the temptation to go and buy new things, and I become more grateful for what I've got. And it's great because so often we grab items that are our go-tos, and by having some time for creative play as an element of self-care, I've put together so many amazing outfits that I never think of or never have time to when I'm in a rush. And as I said, it makes me get so much more use out of my capsule wardrobe. Number three is investing times in lists. I'm not a nutcase when it comes to lists, but having a few lists around me really helped me feel a sense of, I guess, organization, purpose, and direction. I don't need to have a list for absolutely everything in my life, but having some lists help me get to the end of the week and feel proud that I've gotten through not everything on the list, but I've prioritized my responsibilities, my deadlines, and I've been there for people that have needed me, particularly around my work responsibilities. Now, some of these lists might be meals that I want to make during the week, and then I will obviously program them, plug them into my diary. I will also put together a list of things that I need to get done for my work and things that I need to get done to feel a sense of organization in my own personal life. And that might be things like picking up my dry cleaning, making sure I prioritize 3 exercise sessions per week and a couple of meditation sessions, things that fill my cup and that make me feel a sense of self-care and self-worth. Number four, I love, love, love to invest in catching up on some YouTube videos, some recipes, and even a documentary. I really want to get better at the way that I apply makeup, learn different techniques and styles so that I can create a whole range of different looks. So if I get some time to myself for self-care, I love to watch a few videos on YouTube. And I have found that just watching a couple of videos here and there quickly improves the way that I apply my makeup. And it makes me feel more creative. It encourages me also to play more with all the beauty products that I own, and I get more use out of those beauty products, and I get more gratitude and appreciation for those beauty and skincare products. I'm also trying to make sure that I include more vegetarian meals in my diet. So using the time to look up some new and creative, simple and easy recipes and meals to make around plant-based meals. And of course, I love to feed my brain. I love to watch all sorts of documentaries from a wide range of different subject matters. It feels like a multivitamin for my brain. The fifth thing that I love to do for self-care is reading. Now, I'm a really slow reader. Don't ever lend me a book because it'll take you about 5 years to get it back again. I can only read a few pages at a time because I often fall asleep, and I really like to read slowly so that I can absorb all the messages, all the advice on each page. So at the moment I am reading Kindfulness, which I'm loving, and literally I only need to read a couple of pages and I get so much information from it that I actually have to put it down and start thinking about it and processing all the wisdom and advice. So taking some time to read a novel, whether it be a self-help book, for me a fantastic investment in my time for self-care. The sixth thing that I love to do for self-care, and this is frugal and it's really quick and easy, and that is to light a scented candle. There is something incredibly spiritual and sacred about lighting a candle, the flicking of the match, just sitting with it and watching it burn, the scent that it spreads around the room. It almost feels like a warm spiritual blanket that's there to cleanse and protect you. It puts me into a meditative zone and helps me be incredibly present, calm any nerves, and get a sense of, I guess, purpose and direction again. And then the seventh thing I love to invest my time in for self-care, and that is meditation. I've shared with you guys in various other YouTube videos that I love HoloSync. I have been using HoloSync meditation for, I think, close to 18, 19, maybe even 20 years. It is really easy to quickly slip into a meditative zen zone. You have to listen to it with headphones. It's incredibly important. But by investing, you know, half an hour, even once a week, it has a profound impact in my mental well-being. Quite often when I listen to this and I have a conversation or something happens and it might be like triggered, or it might be something really antagonistic that someone says, you know, or even if Tom's just being a bit of a stirrer and likes to wind me up because he says I'm easy to get to, I will find that if I've been listening to this and investing some time in this, it's like an out-of-body experience. It's like I step out, can see what's going on, and have this zero reaction, turning down the noise, turning down all the anxiety and frustration that happens in everyone's life, no matter what is going on and where you are in the world. This is incredibly helpful. Now, I have linked in the video description box below a list of all the things that I do, and obviously links to all the things that I do to make it really helpful for you if you want to learn more about what I do for self-care, particularly during isolation and lockdown laws. I really hope by me sharing with you these tips, which I have to also point out are really frugal, they help you create a sense of calmness, tranquility, organization, self-care, and self-love in your world, no matter where you are in the world. Now, please, I would love to hear from you as to what things you do for your own self-care. I'm always grateful and appreciate the advice that you impart back on me. Now, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube account, please make sure you do, and make sure that notification bell is switched on. And of course, please make sure that you are following me on Instagram at Sugar Mama, because I reply back to your comments, I see them, I acknowledge them, and I try and help you as much as I possibly can. And of course, we all pray that the coronavirus passes, we get on top of this, and we all come out resilient, stronger than we ever have been before.